Okay, I'm going to go ahead and work the test. The y-intercept is 2, so you go up 2, put a dot. The slope is 3 over 1, so you're going to go up 3 over 1. Second one, you're going to go down 3. The slope is 1 over 1, so you're going to go up 1 over 1. And where they cross is the solution. They're not going to cross till somewhere down here. But again, I'm just checking your graphs. This one, the y-intercept is 1, so you're going to go up 1. The slope is 1 over 1, so you're going to go up 1 over 1. And it looks like that. The second one, you got to get y by itself. So subtract 2x and divide by 2. So you're going to go down 1 and put a dot. Then you're going to go down 1 to the right 1. And again, where they cross is the solution. The next one, substitution. To do substitution, what you're going to do is take all of this and put it in place of y. Subtract 2x. You're going to add and divide by 2. So you get x equals 2. 4 times 2 is 8, minus 7 is 1. So there's your answer. Okay, next. On the next one, you're going to do substitution as well. So you're going to take all of this and put it in place of the y. It's going to be a negative 2x. You're going to bring the 18 over there. That becomes a negative 20 because the 18 becomes a negative. Divide by negative 2 and you get 10. So x equals 10. Come on right here and put a 10. So you get negative 5 times 10 is negative 50. Plus 9 is a negative 41. The next one, to do substitution, you got to get one of these by itself. So I'm going to subtract 2x, and I'm going to get y equals negative 2x minus 1. Take all of this and substitute it in place of the y. So you're going to get negative 2x minus 1 minus 3x equals negative 16. This gives me a negative 5x. I'm going to add 1 to the other side. So I get negative 5x equals a negative 15. And I'm going to divide by negative 5 and get x equals 3. A negative divided by a negative is a positive. I take 3 and plug it right here. That gives me a negative 6. Minus 1 is a negative 7. Elimination. To do elimination, what you're going to do is line them up. Well, these already cancel out. So you get x is equal to 8. Now, you pick whichever one you like. I like the top one. So 4 times 8 is 32. I'm going to subtract 32. And whatever you get there, 6, I guess it's 24. You can check my math. But I think it's 24. And it actually should be a negative 24. Okay, finally, the last one. Since this is a plus and a minus, and this is a 5, I would multiply it by 2 to get a 10. So down here, 2 times 2 is 4x plus 10y is equal to 40. This cancels. So I get 7y is equal to 77. Y is equal to 11. So here I put y is equal to 11. And then I pick whichever one I like. I like the top one. So I get 2x plus 55 is equal to 20. Subtract 2x is equal to a negative 35, I guess it is. And then divide by 2. I guess that's a negative 17.5. All right, you can check some of my little adding and subtracting with your calculator, but that's pretty much how you do the test. And there's no backside. So I would suggest reworking the problems and learning them and retesting. Have a nice day.